Invisible men are always cool, and the great thing is, they're easy to cast because of obvious reasons. Actually, that's what I wish I was when my ex-wife or IRS come knocking at my door. Forget I said that. Patrick, we've been recording for a while. Can we take a break now?
Well, we're a little behind, but sure, let's take a fiber.
Oh, man. Man alive, that feels great to get those headphones off. Whew. Whew. That's a load off my shoulders. Which, it's actually a load off my head, which is a load off my shoulder. But anyway. You know, I gotta level with you. Most of the cast, not that great. Worst acting I've seen, probably. Yeah, we'd shoot some scenes a dozen times just to get it right. Hey, I want to... Hey, you're not recording any of this, right?
Oh, nah. It's all good. I'll just make a note to edit this stuff out.
Just pick up a film reel? So that's what happened to all my missing footage. Oh, how did I ever let this make it into the final cut?
Thank you.
Jonathan, that was an odd one. He used to tell me that after he makes it big, he doesn't want to be Jonathan Digby anymore. He wants to be J. Dig. He thought it would start a trend or something. Can you imagine that? The first letter of his name and then the first syllable of his last name? It's so absurd. That's the sort of thing that would never catch on. Oh, especially in the entertainment industry. We had these space cogs strewn across the planet for the heroes to pick up to explain how they're able to keep improving all their equipment.
But how does adding gears to something like a baton or sword suddenly make it better? I mean, how do gears even factor in?
Let me stop you right there. Are you an engineer?
Well, technically, I'm an audio engineer.
Exactly. Didn't think so. Hey, keep that in mind next time you criticize things outside your realm of experience. have any idea what sort of blood, sweat, and tears went into creating this army and making them all move around on cue? No, seriously, do you? Because I'm still stumped by this. I watch the scenes, and I just, flabbergasted by the amount of work someone must have done to make all this happen. Tried a lot of names before we settled on Dick Starspeed. Let's see, we had Lance Laser, Gary Galaxy, Samuel Satellite, Nacho Nova. That was my favorite. Yeah, we did a whole lot of those same first letter thing for a while there. The execs wanted us to go with Dick, though. For a while, we were gonna go with Dick Missile, I think. The studio didn't care much, as long as we steered clear of Uranus and black holes. Dick Missile penetrating deep into a black hole, then going to Uranus. That would have been a knee slapper. Burst in her eye on our first day of shooting and tried asking for the rest of the day off. You expect us to pay you nothing to do nothing? I told her. But then it gave me the idea for these exploding eyeball monsters, so I let her take a full 15-minute break for lunch that day.
I'm
gone a little overboard with how the heroes are always destroying things. The prop master Ralph had intended to use some for multiple scenes, but nope, not the way our actors were busting through them. Ralph ended up having to rebuild each of those boxes and statues and pots and all that for practically every last scene. That's okay, though, because I know he loved it, as did our second prop master who we ended up hiring after Ralph quit. These sleep chambers were pretty much a mystery. Just how in the world do they work? Are they teleporting the heroes somewhere, shrinking them down? Who knows?
But, sir, shouldn't you know? I mean, it's your movie.
Patrick, a director can't know everything about his film. If he did, it would be no fun for him to watch it. Also, I called in sick a lot, so a lot of the scenes were handled by my cinematographer. I was going through a phase back in the 70s. Always had mood rings on. Several of them. I used to pick a color, and then I'd make the actors just keep doing the scene over and over until my rings turned that color. That's how you know we're achieving the right tone for the scene, you know. He used to drive Stacy bananas. She'd call me names and swear, and I'd just say, huh? I don't need a ring to tell your mood right now. She hated that. For the evil replicator, I wanted a really awesome, unique new robot creature. I had even envisioned a mix between a praying mantis and a tractor. I drew this doodle on a napkin and showed it to the special effects lead, but I knew the answer when his face went pale. I mean, how much more work would it have been to squeeze in one extra monster in production? Thank you. Hey, you know the best part about releasing this new DVD will be? All that sweet, sweet royalty money. Man, I can't wait till that starts rolling in. Of course, the old VHS we put out back in the 80s and the TV syndication pay out royalties too. I'm still waiting on my first payment from all that.
Your days are numbered, Dr. Peculiar. There is nowhere to run, and I have transmitted our entire conversation to my father.
Indeed she has. You've cheated me, Doctor, and used my gold for your own schemes.
Ah, so pedestrian. The moneylender subtracting the efforts of the scientist.
Did you actually think you could get away with this?
Actually, I still do. My positronic shield consists of 8 energy rings. As long as even one of them remains intact.
Silence, traitor! I grow tired of your incessant techno babble.
As I was saying, my shield is invulnerable to your meager weaponry. And because I am an evil genius, I have fastened the energy rings to a gigantic mutant octopus! And as for you, my dear...
Thank you.
System. You know, because it's an octopus and it has many arms. Jeez. Okay. All right. Okay. We'll be right back.
You can kiss your cowardly shield goodbye, Doctor.
Tut tut. Did you really think I wouldn't have another deadly trap prepared?
Your shred eliminated it.
That's all, folks. The greedy Emperor gets what's coming to him. The scientist learns he shouldn't play God. Spectacular monsters, large-scale pyrotechnics. This is what sci-fi is all about. And about now, we should be seeing the ending title card, the credits, and all the usual fanfare and the music. Hey, let's not forget, hold up. That's not right. Huh? Patrick, what is all this? What is this footage you're showing me?
Sir, are you all right?
Well, goodness gracious, man, of course not. You got the wrong movie.
But, sir,
where'd they get this footage? What, did they film it when I was in the restroom? Impossible. I always used to make Carl go with me to discuss our next shot. Part 4? Okay, now. Patrick, something's fishy. Something's real fishy going on here. I'm gonna make some phone calls. This isn't right.
Patrick, is there a payphone around here somewhere?
Jeez. I think someone forgot his movie had 4 chapters in it. They always stick me with the worst projects for these DVDs. Starting Monday, looking for a new job.
Greetings. We have been watching you.
Unidentified life form detected.
We are the true Gravorians, the original inhabitants of this planet. There are still many perils within this tower. We must take care that no one else is watching us.
Would you look at those costumes? Yeah, this is definitely made by the same crew. It's made from those inflatable air dancer things you see outside stores. Oh, they must have borrowed them from Emperor Greg's used car lot. No doubt about it. If the director was good at anything, it was figuring out how to do things as cheap and cheesy as can be. Children in those suits. Or did they actually cast a bunch of little people? Casting call, 3-foot-tall actors needed. Must be okay with exploitation and standing around in a poorly ventilated papier-mâché suit all day. There we go. No B-movie is complete without crawling brains. Who comes up with this stuff? The thing about brain creatures is, they should be smart, right? I mean, think about it. A brain being smart is like it. These things just crawl towards the hero and get squished. Way to go, brains. Still confused by these guys. Did these brains once human or something? Did they lose their will to live? Now their bodies are gone? Oh, maybe they're like cow brains. That's why they aren't so smart. Or maybe like a manatee brain. Yeah. Water cows are adorable. Right, and yep, here comes the crocodile alien men, right on cue. Where did they come from? Are they all friends with the bobblehead aliens?
Hospitable Gravorian brothers. They cannot comprehend your importance. We have been studying the universe, and we believe you hold the key to its true nature.
Whatever do you mean?
Have you noticed you haven't died? Despite insurmountable odds against you, the universe is protecting you.
Nonsense! We are alive because of our talents and our skills.
I see, you'll need convincing. Behold, the Aeronautical Disruptor.
It looks like a pair of scissors.
I admit, we don't know how the artifact works, but see what happens when I use it on an airborne object.
Wow. Are they breaking the fourth wall?
You missed! And yet you still killed it? How is this possible?
The secret is to aim high. See you next time.
They are breaking the fourth wall. For that? Something cooler than scissors? I get the whole thing about the strings, but that's like fighting against the Galactic Empire with a toothbrush because you discovered that they all have bad breath.
Disruptor in action? It contradicts everything we understand about flight.
The phenomenon is a strange one indeed. But what are you getting at?
By studying your language, we've discovered there are some sounds which cannot be uttered. It's taken our elders many generations to create a list of these magic words. Please, take this tablet and read it in a loud, clear voice.
What trickery is this? It's nothing but a list of curses and foul language.
You see, even you can't speak the magic words.
I most certainly could. I just choose not to use such vulgarity.
Then the second artifact upholds the prophecy. Tread carefully. The others will try to destroy you.
Yes, about that. Why are the other aliens trying to kill us?
The others fear you, chosen ones. You have the power to alter reality. The naysayers want to silence you.
Oh, I get it. With their G rating, they weren't allowed to swear in the movie. Mix of Monsters is one of the high points of the film. It's not like there's any consistency between all these B-movie monsters, but they somehow steal the show. Big snail there looks like my old Aunt Bertha.
Thank you.
were these aliens thinking when they built this place? Like, they couldn't just build a normal stairway? Were tiles that appear and disappear right under your feet really the best option for getting up this tower?